We thank you for joining us as we continue our study with Paul White pertaining to Hebrews chapter 6, verse 1 and 2. And we're looking at the concept of what Christians should leave behind and what they should go on to. Not understanding our identity keeps us shackled, keeps us in bondage, and keeps us from understanding that when we try to do it ourselves, we are just producing dead works. And if we do not go through Christ by the leading of the Holy Spirit, we're never going to have the maturity that the writer of Hebrews says you must go on to, or you're going to continue to stay on milk your entire life. So we pick up with our study today in Hebrews chapter 6, verse 2. It says, of the doctrine of baptisms. Paul, as writer, lists baptisms as plural there. That conflicts with one baptism in some people's minds. So give us an explanation on what the writer is talking about, the doctrine of baptisms, plural, versus being one baptism, as Paul would say.
Okay, let's remember our audience is Hebrews. These are Jewish believers who've come from Judaism into the faith, and one of the tenets of Judaism is washings.
Correct.
In fact, outside of the holy place at the temple, or the tabernacle, if you drag it back to Moses, is the brazen laver, and a large pool, a sea, if you would, S-E-A, an ocean, so to speak, of water that the priest would use as washings when he prepared the sacrifice. But there was also a whole list, a whole doctrine of baptisms for Jews that had nothing to do with being dunked in rivers, but had to do with the various washings for uncleanliness. There was a washing for a woman when she was in her time of the month. There was a washing so that she could be cleansed. There was a washing that you had after you slept with your spouse, that you had to be physically clean ceremonially. There was a washing for that. There was
touch anything dead.
Touched a dead body, human or animal. Right. There was a ceremony cleansing. Of washing. We talked a little bit about that when we jumped forward to Hebrews 9 and that purification. But this was such a concept of Judaism that it was a constant issue. Even in the ministry of Jesus, you'll recall, he goes into town and his disciples are picking corn, and they eat without washing their hands. I'm kind of mixing two stories. They eat without washing their hands, and the Pharisees lose their minds. How can your disciples do this? What they're really hearkening back to is the doctrine of baptisms. Why are they not cleaning themselves before they eat? And Jesus says, well, it's not what goes into the man that defiles him, it's what comes out. So the author of Hebrews is saying, let's leave behind that constant purification process. You can't just cause people to leave things behind. You have to give them something to go into. Okay? If I'm going to convince you, you got to leave that behind, it's got to be because you've went into something better. Well, Paul says in Ephesians 4, we have one Lord, one faith, one baptism. And so the concept of Christianity is not baptism even by water. Water was an identification with what Jesus had done at Jordan. But baptism into Christ was the faith on Christ, being baptized, being merged, being immersed, being flooded with who he is.
Being in him.
In him. In fact, it's part of the Great Commission. Go make disciples, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I don't think that has very much to do with the words you say over someone when you dunk them.
Right.
That is immerse them in the knowledge. Baptize them in the knowledge that they have a Father, they are a Son, and they are led by the Spirit. That is the one baptism of Christianity. It's that idea that we've came in through that one-time immersion. For a Jew, they kept going back to the temple and doing rewashings. They kept seeing themselves as dirty and re-cleaning themselves. The cleaning that we get, Paul says in Ephesians 5, and this is interesting chronologically. Ephesians 4, there's one baptism. Ephesians 5, he says Christ washes you off with the water of his words. So if you're not satisfied with your one baptism, it's okay. Because every time Jesus speaks, it's like cool water washing over your body. In fact, that scripture that is so famous in grace circles, and we've dealt with this, you and I together, of 1 John 1:9, if a man confess God is faithful and just to forgive him his sins and to cleanse him. The word cleanse in the Greek, continually cleanse of all unrighteousness.
A one-time happening, but of
lasting effect.
A lasting effect daily, moment by moment, second by second.
So he's really trying to pull that Jewish believer away from the concept of external washings, because that made their conscience feel better. Not that you don't wash your hands or taking care of germs, but not to do it in a spiritual sense to be spiritually clean. He says, no, you're better than that. You're more mature than that. You don't have to go be physically washed to be spiritually clean. You ought to be mature enough to realize that you've had your one baptism in Christ.
So when he asked the readers of Hebrews to leave baptisms, as you alluded to, the many different cleansing process, sacrifice that for the one baptism that we have in Christ.
Yes.
And if we take and place our faith in that one baptism, we are cleansed. Our old man is done away with. We are now have resurrection life, and we are not only cleansed, but we will be constantly, continually cleansed moment by moment the rest of our life.
Absolutely. By the words he speaks over us.
So with that, I can feel safe, secure, that I not only was cleansed, but I am cleansed.
Yeah.
Even though, as you alluded to on the last program, that we sin today, go sin tomorrow, but I'm still cleansed.
Still cleansed.
And that's a problem that people have with the grace message. Yeah. That, well, you've got to do something to alleviate and be clean again. And my cleansing comes from the mentality that I have to offer some method that Christ will say, all right, because you did that, I will now reckon you cleansed. When we can only be cleansed by the blood.
Well, I would throw this in. I think our issue is that we think the purpose of Christianity is to stop sinning.
Mm-hmm.
And that is not why Jesus died on the cross, so you'd stop sinning. He wanted to live his life through you. The purpose of Christianity is so that God can live in you and through you and have relationship with you.
Throughout.
Yeah.
You know, constantly from the day we accept Christ.
Absolutely.
That is his goal, to have life through his creation, no matter what that creation is doing at any time. We thank you for joining us today. Hope you will join us again for Emmaus Road Podcast.